that's good, gentlemen. A brand new food video. I don't know what the fuck to call this, but yeah, y'all read the title correctly. I made Jabaguri, or Ramdam, as it's known, or I guess the translated version of it's called Parasite. Because you guys know that I saw the movie recently for one of my film classes. It was one of the required screens for one of my film classes. So shout out to my professor for finally giving me an excuse to finally watch Parasite. Yeah, so, and obviously afterwards, you know, the food itself looked pretty good, so I decided, you know what, fuck it, let's make it. So, I got the meals together, had my mom help me cook this up, and, yeah, man, and, I guess I should probably tell Parasite for before I get right. Loved Parasite, I obviously saw all the hype surrounding it, of course, you know, I watched, yeah, of course, saw that, and got that, you know, swept the Oscars a couple years ago, and I was like, alright, it was like the same thing that kind of happened to me with, like, when Your Name first came out for my anime peeps out there. Where I'm like, alright, everybody is sucking this movie's dick like it's the second coming of Christ. The greatest thing since sliced bread. For, well, back in 2016, it was both Your Name and A Silent Voice, but mostly Your Name. That everybody and their goddamn grandmother was fucking praising it. You know, Mother's Basement made his video about how the Oscars refused to acknowledge anime and shit, unless it's like Ghibli or whatever. You know, which sci-fi and horror fans say hello, and also comic book fans as well. We say hello. But yeah, man. So yeah, I love the movie. It's definitely worth the hype. I think it's a masterpiece, man. Seriously, Korea has been like really stepping up and really making their presence known recently. Like, we had, of course, Squid Game. We had Parasite, of course. There was also like Old Boy back in like 03. But of course, we had Squid Game a couple of, like last year that popped off. Of course, Parasite as well popped off. I've been getting into Korean horror a lot recently with like Train to Busan. There's a bunch of other horror movies that I've heard from Korea that are really good. Silence was another phenomenal movie from Korea that I love that has amazing performances. Like, low key, Korean actors are low key built there. I swear to God, man, the best performances I've seen in recent memory. From like movies I've seen recently or whatever, come from Korea, man. Literally, Korean actors low key built different, fam. But yeah, man. So yeah, I have as a film student, I decided, you know, fuck it, let's create Ramdam and let's, you know, see if we can get this work in the algorithm. But yeah, man, I also got my chopsticks ready because, as like Mudo said,
we're not savages.
So yeah, let's try this and see if I even did this right. All right, go. Yo, hold on. Hold on one sec. Hold on one second. Hold on. Yo. Yeah. Yo. Yo, this actually slaps. What the fuck? I was paranoid if I made it right or not. But, yeah, man. Yo, and it's spicy too, got a little bit of a kick to it, but yo, this unironically slaps, yo. Yo, hold on. In case you guys wonder, no, I didn't use fucking Wagyu beef. I didn't use it because you can't really get that in the States. But yeah, just like my mom got whatever meat she gets for my tacos were. Still good shit, man, yo. Yo, bro, this actually unironically slaps. But I don't know if I mentioned this before, but if you guys want to know my full thoughts on Parasite, check out my review I wrote on my Letterboxd, because my film professor for this semester anyway, I'm kind of hoping this doesn't become a thing for my last 2 years, because sometimes I'd be watching movies pretty late, and I don't want to be like, bro, I just want to go to bed when it's like 11 or whatever. I just want to go to bed and not be like sitting on my phone on the Letterboxd app for like 30 minutes trying to write down the review. For movies. I mean, on one hand, it's kind of fun to write them, get my thoughts out there, so at least somewhere, you guys have somewhere that you can go to get my full thoughts on specific movies when I don't review them for the channel. But at the same time, it's just like, bro, I just want to go to fuck to sleep. And I'll be sitting here for like 30 minutes trying to get this review done. Write this review, but yeah. Bruh. Bro. No. Bro, yo, no lie, though, this unironically slaps, yo. And my, yo. Bruh. Alright, man. I'm gonna end this video here, yo. So the whole video is this ain't even fucking mukbang, me just eating this. Bro. Yo. Yo, bro, yo, hold on. Let me give him one more vibe. If I can get this piece of steak. Jesus Christ, what's this thing attached to? Ah, there it is. God damn it.
Bro. If you have like a fucking
like an Asian market near you, or you want to put the shit off Amazon or whatever,
yo, make this shit. It is really fucking good. What the?
I was paranoid if I made it wrong, if I was even gonna like it. But yo, this shit slaps. Yo, yo. I guess that's two cup noodles. Instant noodles I love. The stir fry cup noodles. These slap it, of course. Jabaguri or Ramdam. And no, like this scene where she's actually when Park family's mom, I forget her name, is she's making this, bro. That was probably my favorite scene in the entire movie. Not only because the song that I was playing, which I'll probably have that song playing in the background of this video, because fucking why not? But the editing of it all, and yo, the camera work of Parasite. Bruh. Yo, Bong Joon-ho, if I believe that's the director's name. Hold on, I gotta make sure I gotta get this right. Well, let me check. Let me pull up my letterbox real quick. So yeah. And well, if you guys do check out my review on my letterbox, you guys want to know my full thoughts on it? Want to follow you, boy, while you're at it. Although I should warn you, my reviews and my scores may give you an aneurysm. As I've been told, I have shit taste in movies, and my tastes are very inconsistent. If I can find it, Parasite. Yeah, Bong Joon-ho. Yo, bruh. Bong Joon-ho, man, says that man directed the fuck out of that movie. And yo, his camera work, some of the best I have ever seen, man. Seriously. And the performances were fucking incredible, man. Fucking incredible. Especially, the fuck was his name? Song Kang-ho, who plays Kim Kai-tek. I probably butchered that name, I'm sorry. He was phenomenal, man. Him especially, man. I think he was amazing. And just that whole movie, it was just fascinating to watch. Just watching this family bullshit their way to riches. I'm talking about I'm still getting got there. But yeah, his performance was amazing. I loved that part. But yeah, as I was saying before my webcam cut out on me, it was just fascinating just watching the Kim family bullshit their way to riches and just all the intricacies. They're like, seriously, I mentioned this is something I mentioned in my review of Letterboxd. Like, I can't get over a fucking what this is. But it's like, this was like Paul Heyman levels bullshitting. For my wrestling fans, I get the reference of how Paul Heyman got into MSG the first time. Like, bro, it was like that level of bullshitting, and you're just like, wow. And then, of course, after the Jabaguri scene, when the movie kicks off into second gear, bro, forget about it. The movie gets even better than it was beforehand. Like, yo. And back to the Jabaguri scene, another thing about that made that scene so fucking great. And Loki makes an entire, you could teach an entire film class just off that scene alone. You know, it's just like with like the sound design, the editing, and how it uses tension, and how Bong Joon-ho, uses tension, the camera work, and everything. Was like when, the kid is climbing up the stairs, the piano's going higher in pitch as he's going up there, it's perfectly timed, it's going, as he's going up the stairs, bro. Peak cinema. So yeah, Parasite, it's worth the hype and it's worth all the Oscars. I mean, I personally would have given it a joke, but that's just me. That's just the comic book fan in me. It is a fantastic film, man. And yeah, highly recommend you guys check this out if you have not seen Parasite. It is worth the hype. And it is a fucking masterpiece, man. Cheers. All right. I'm not trying to turn this into a goddamn mukbang video, so I'm gonna stop here, ladies and gentlemen. I ain't Nikata Avakala. You will not see me get going 200 pounds heavier live on camera. No, sir. No, sir. But yeah, man, I'm gonna end here. Obviously, I'm going to finish this off camera and enjoy it because, God, this shit is fucking delicious, man. Seriously. One more look for y'all. And also, I don't know if I mentioned this before, but my mom added green onions to it. Pretty good. But, yeah, man. It slaps. Just like Parasite, Ramdam fucking slaps, man. Seriously. I recommend you guys try this out and make it yourself and try it, because it's fucking delicious, man. It's not that hard. There's plenty of YouTube videos out there if you guys that have never stepped foot in the kitchen like I have. Shout out to my mom for obviously helping making this. She took care of the steak. Yeah, man. Fucking awesome. Can't wait. I'm really looking forward to eating the rest of this. But anyway, guys. That's what I'm going to end off. Like I said before, if you guys want to know my full thoughts on Parasite, check out the link in the description box below to my full review I left on Letterboxd, if I remember to put it in when I upload this. But, yeah, man. Anyway, guys, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Leave a like if you did, subscribe if you're new. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter, if you like, links in the description box below. And as always, come back for more. See you guys next time. You're welcome.